Hello to be in the internet. Welcome back to more of Geek 3. What the hell do Samurai have to sing about? Chopping off heads?
It's a samurai musical set in ancient Japan.
A samurai musical? Is that even a genre? Well, I'm impressed. You know their stuff, Mia.
Oh, Maya's the real fan. I just picked up a little.
Samurai Summer starring Jackhammer. I suppose it looks like it's been hanging here for years.
This is one of Maya's favorite movies.
Maybe we should replace the poster in the office with this one?
That would be kind of sad.
Oh, that's nothing new. Okay. Do you know anything about this?
Hey, that's a Steel Samurai trading card. I collect those, actually. I'm one card away from a complete set.
A complete set?
Yeah, a set of one of each card. Huh. Wait! That's it! That's the card I need! You don't know how long I've been looking for it! I don't care what kind of girl you might think I am, I need that card! But please, I beg you, please trade with me!
Trade with you?
Yes, trade cards! Look, I'll even trade you an ultra-rare premium card!
Trade me a... huh?
Yes, it's a good deal for your ultra-rare! Please!
She has doubles of the ultra-rare premium, but can't get the one ultra-rare card that she's like, whatever. Phoenix, can't you see she's desperate?
What's everyone getting so excited about? Okay.
Really? Thanks! Then, this is for you.
Ultra-rare premium card added to the court record!
Yahoo!
And there she goes.
Doesn't doing good things like that make you feel great?
Yeah, it does. What's she gonna do now that she has a complete set?
Summon Satan?
Oh, jeez, okay.
Or whatever the Steel Samurai equivalent of it is. You know, some ancient, like, fourth form, final tier god that has an angel wing and a devil wing and multiple different kinds of horns and halos and,
yeah,
you know, all kinds of other, and multiple heads, clearly, with each with multiple faces facing each direction.
Also, I just remembered that we have Mia with us, so
I'm gonna shoot. All the eyes shoot lasers, all of the mouths breathe fire, and they glow green.
I just realized we have Mia with us, so these things will be different now. Huh, so normal. I was expecting some cool snacks like popcorn, at least.
Look at this, spaghetti in a soda can?
Spaghetti? Wouldn't just the sauce come out of the noodle salt stay stuck inside?
Best when slammed. I guess they want you to drink it in one gulp?
Slamming spaghetti? Right.
Slamming spaghetti! It's like, it sounds like a weird, like, thing, like, Spider-Man Noir would shout whenever he's, like, surprised.
Yeah.
You know? Slamming spaghetti!
Looks like one of those electric powered bicycles. I don't know about these. I mean, what's the point?
It makes it a lot easier to go up hills.
Where have I heard that line before? Ah. See this card?
Yeah, so... wait! That's it! That's the last Ultra Rare Premium card I need! Come on, give it to me, please! You gotta give it to me!
Wow, I've never seen so eager. Right, okay. How about a trade?
You're on! I'll give you a Samurai Spear and throw an Evil Magic Trick to boot!
No. Not that kind of trade. I don't want cards. I want information.
Huh? You sure? Fine by me.
He's gonna trade you, like, super, like, low-tier common cards for it. Like, what? That's not even a fair trade!
Yeah.
Mr. Fair Trade from before. Like, I was blackmailing you with, you know, your card, and then you were like, oh, pff, but it's a double anyway.
Yeah.
Like, well, fine. Now I do have something you need.
He was probably thinking, you know, because we're just a dumb adult, we probably wouldn't know any better.
Right.
Yeah.
Anyway. Okay, Phoenix, let's hear what he has to say. If he knows something that could help us, we could have him take the stand tomorrow.
So you like the Steel Samurai?
He's so cool.
I guess.
You're just judging him by his looks. You have to look at his actions, at his life.
I'm being lectured on life by a grade schooler?
You like him too, don't you?
Me? Yeah, I love the Steel Samurai.
So tell me, what's your favorite thing about the Steel Samurai?
His fighting skills!
Do you think fighting skills would be the right one?
That sounds the most, like, energetic kid-like thing that comes out.
Gotta think of something. I like it when he, vanquishes his foes.
Yeah, Wazam! The Steel Samurai always wins! Always! Check this out, it's my fan album!
What the? What picture of the Steel Samurai?
I go to every live performance!
Those stupid publicity stunts where they beat each other up in public?
I always take pictures when the Steel Samurai lands a final blow! Wazam! I got them all! I never missed one! A perfect collection! Check it out! My new digital camera!
Wow, that's very impressive. The newest model, isn't it?
You bet, lady! I just got it for my birthday! My album has a name, wanna hear it? The Steel Samurai, Path to Glory! The Steel Samurai always wins! Always! Hey, if you want this, you can have it, lady!
Really? Are you sure?
Yeah, I took these with a digital camera. I got all the data at home so I can always make another one.
Well, then I'm happy to accept. Thank you.
What's with these people always giving stuff to Mia? What a life. You were here on the day of the incident, right?
Yeah.
Did you see anything unusual?
Cody. Cody, he needs to know because he's fighting for justice. Isn't that the Steel Samurai's motto? For great justice? You have to help us fight for great justice too.
I saw everything.
Well, well, we might get some useful information out of him yet. Cody, I need to ask you something very important. What did you see on the day of the incident?
I got here the day around 2. I had to come in through the woods out back so that old lady wouldn't see me. I got kinda lost though. I was in there maybe half an hour or so. And I finally got to the studio. After that...
What is it, Cody?
The Steel Samurai killed the bad guy! He used his samurai spear, just like always! One shot, one kill! It happened so fast, I got scared. When I went home after... I went home after that.
I see. That must have been hard for you.
Man, you say those nice things, and it's so obvious you aren't speaking from the heart.
Right. Mia?
Yes?
I think we can say for sure this means the Steel Samurai did it.
True enough.
Their director has an alibi, so it wasn't him.
Indeed.
So, the only person left who could have been is Will Powers.
I have to admit, it's kind of a shock. But if you put this boy on the witness stand, your client will be guilty for sure.
Let's not call him then.
I think that would be wise. Best to leave this one alone.
I think it's Gumshoe.
Yeah, not so fast, pal! I heard everything! This boy here's a key witness, and he's under police protection starting now! Come on, son. You've got a rendezvous with me down in the precinct.
No, I ain't going. Wah!
That didn't go so well. We're back to 0 leads, and now we have a serious handicap in court.
What are we gonna do, Mia?
Well, I really need to be going. Don't worry, Phoenix. I'm sure you'll be fine.
Whoa! Come to the trial tomorrow, please! I need you there!
Phoenix, can I ask you something? Do you really believe that Mr. Powers is innocent?
Of course he is!
That's all I wanted to hear. Excellent. I'll see you in court, then.
Great! Thanks, Mia.
See you soon. What now? What? We're back to square one! Like, completely!
Yeah. Well, it wouldn't be a game if there were no challenge. And up until now, we've always known who the villain is beforehand.
Yeah. We know who the villain is. It's the Steel Samurai. Or at least the person in the outfit.
Yeah.
But... who the fuck else could have been wearing it?
Mr. Wright?
Yes?
Why do you look so unhappy?
Nothing. Really, it's nothing. Right, Mia? Uh-oh, she looks even unhappier.
Phoenix, your client is now practically a dead man walking. Perhaps that's why I feel particularly close to him.
This is no time for dead people jokes, please.
You know, we're going into this trial utterly defenseless. Yet, if Mr. Powers is truly innocent, we should be able to find something overlooked in the evidence to prove it.
Something overlooked?
We have to find something, Phoenix, today. It's that, or lose the trial.
This isn't going to be easy.
So all this investigating everything up to now means nothing, because now we're going to get the, like, ultimate anime climactic, you know, thing that'll give us the thing to win the day, right?
Well, it doesn't necessarily mean nothing, because now we have more witnesses. More people to be called onto the stand and to cross-examine.
Yeah, alright. Court is now in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers. The prosecution is ready, Your Honor.
The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Very well. Mr. Edgeworth, your opening statement, please. An unexpected fact has come to the attention of the court. Yesterday, we learned that there were other people present at the studios. Today, I would like to show evidence proving they had nothing to do with the murder. Very well. You may call your first witness, Mr. Edgeworth.
I wonder if he'll be the producer.
The prosecution calls Mr. Sal Manella to the stand.
Or that director.
Will the witness state his name and profession?
How rude can you get? You don't know me! I'm the director! I'm with the Steel Samurai! New brothel!
Sal Manella, I'm a director, television.
Were you at Global Studios on the day of the murder?
Yes, Your Honor.
Very well. Please testify to the court about the events of that day. Phoenix, let's start by picking this testimony apart. If Powers is innocent, you know what that means. Someone in the trailer on that day did it.
You're right. She doesn't waste any time putting on the pressure.
I was at the studios from around 9 that morning. During the morning, I was doing, an action scene run-through. It took a lot more time than I thought it would. I hear that everyone else ate lunch in the employee area, but I had a meeting in a Studio 2 trailer, so I ended up skipping lunch. We were in the meeting until around 4. During the meeting, well, I'm pretty sure no one left their chairs. That's about it.
The time of Mr. Hammer's death was 2:30 p.m. And according to your testimony, you were in a meeting at the time. Mr. Wright, you may begin your cross-examination.
Yes, Your Honor. Is that when you always come into work?
Oh no. I come in all sort of hours. It's the industry way.
Yeah, I know all about freaks in your industry.
Still, FWIW, I was pretty busy all that day, sad face.
Tell us more about that.
In the employee area?
That's right. It was a fight scene between the Steel Samurai and the Evil Magistrate.
Was anyone else at the run-through?
Oh yeah, that security lady was sitting there watching the whole thing. Lol. LOL. She was cheering on Hammer, if you can believe it.
She certainly has the lungs for it. Anyone else?
Nope, just us four.
Why did it go on so long?
I'm pretty sure you've already heard about this, but WP twisted his ankle during the run-through, see?
Oh, right. That's the limp.
Which, of course, led to me missing my lunch. ROFS.
ROFS? Rolling on the floor, starving?
Rawfus!
What exactly did they have for lunch?
T-bone steak! The assistant cooked some up.
Come to think of it, there was a plate with some bones on it in the employee area.
Everyone else, meaning that the witness did not eat with them.
So, in the end, you didn't get to eat?
Yeah, no steak at least. Can you believe it?
That must have been tough.
Phoenix.
Yeah?
Doesn't something about that seem odd to you?
Yeah, it does seem odd now that you mention it. Mr. Manella!
What did you want? Sweats.
When I went to Studio 2, I saw something on the table there. There were two plates, the same kind of plates as the one in the employee area. Who ate lunch there?
Good call! Sweats. I was embarrassed, so I didn't mention it. But I did eat after all.
T-bone steak, you mean?
Yeah, well, I mean, the assistant went through all that trouble. I brought it to the trailer, thinking I could eat it later.
Clearly a man who likes to eat. I suspected as much. So what exactly did you eat? It.
We took one break during the meeting. I wolfed it down then.
Drool. Mental image I will carry with me to my grave. Wait a second. I took a break during the meeting that contradicts his testimony. I'll press on that one a bit more. What were you discussing?
The Steel Samurai story, and our budget. Get this! The sponsors can turn to me and say, Mr. Manila, those scripts of yours are not appropriate for children. Can you believe it?
Actually, I kind of can. So, nobody left the table during that whole meeting? You didn't take a single break?
Well, yeah, not a one, Sweats.
What's he sweating so much about, I wonder? I only had an idea. Wait a second. Maybe I do have an idea. Wait a second. Mr. Manila, you just contradicted yourself. Didn't you tell the court that you ate a T-bone steak during a break?
Oops! Raffle!
Well?
Mr. Manila, what's this all about?
Well, yeah, I guess we did take a break, a little break.
Phoenix, great job! If they took a break, one of them could have gone to the studio during that time.
Your Honor, I call the witness to testify on the court about this break.
Very well. Mr. Manila, your testimony, please.
Uh-oh, Edward is laughing.
Yeah, FWIW, we took a break. Raffle! But it was only 15 minutes. 15! That's only 13 in base 12. Not enough for someone to say, commit murder in Studio 1! L-L-O-L.
I don't know.
That's only just enough time to eat a T-bone steak, if you ask me.
Steams.
Must be an angry thing?
I guess, yeah. Like, you're steaming through the ears or whatever.
I don't think it would even be enough time for that, but that's just me. Very well, you may begin the cross-examination.
Oops. It went like,
yeah. Yeah, I saw. Okay.
Thank you.
Go off. What time exactly did you take this break?
I'd say it was from around 2:30 or so until 2:45.
2:30? That's the time of death. So we could have gone to Studio 1, killed Hammer, and come back. I guess it's possible, time-wise. What were you doing for those 15 minutes?
Eating my T-bone steak. What else?
There were two plates on the table.
Oh, right. The other one was Divas. Sorry. Divasquez.
Okay. Divasquez, the producer.
To eat a T-bone steak and 15 minutes. That's quite a feat.
Why is that?
Haven't we had enough of this pointless... line of questioning? Your Honor, the testimony to this point has made one certain fact painfully clear. The people in the trailer had nothing to do with this murder. It was impossible for any of them to go to Studio One.
What?
Something wrong, Mr. Wright? Surely you aren't suggesting one of the people in the trailer went to Studio One.
Well, Mr. Wright?
Phoenix, this is critical. Think about it before you give your answer.
Do you claim someone from the trailer went to Studio One?
I don't want to write off so many possible suspects, but I can't keep claiming it's the impossible either. I agree that it was impossible for anyone in the trailer to go to the studio at that time.
Haha! I thought you might be thoughtlessly trending on the ice again. But I see you had at least an inkling of the truth.
What do you mean, Mr. Edgeworth?
It's quite simple. Truth, the break in the trailer meeting came right at the time of death. However, the path from there to the scene of the crime was blocked. The fallen Mrs. Monkeyhead barred the way.
Mrs.?
At around 2:15, a strong gust of wind knocked out the studio mascot's head.
Didn't they say it was a Mr. Monkey?
Yeah.
Okay,
whatever. Ergo,
When the people in the trailer took a break at 2:30, the way to the studio was blocked. Blocked by Mrs. Monkey's severed head.
It's actually Mr. Monkey, but Edward has a point. And somehow I feel no desire to correct him.
I believe we have seen enough evidence. I would like to relieve Mr. Manila from the stand.
What? It's over? He even has a ponytail.
I know, in the backwards baseball cap. Not back baseball cap, but like, it's like a visor, but he's wearing it backwards.
Very well. This court's opinion on this case is as follows. We have found that there were several other people in Studio 2 on the day of the murder. However, it is also clear that none of these people could have gone to Studio 1. They, therefore, have no relation to this case. Furthermore, with regards to the photo of the steel samurai, given the size of the costume, no one other than Mr. Powers could have worn it that day. All that is lacking is divisive evidence that he is the one who did it.
Decisive.
That's what I said.
You said divisive.
Oops. Decisive. If we had that, I'm afraid I would have to find Mr. Powers guilty.
Your Honor, the prosecution is pleased to announce that we indeed have decisive evidence. A witness.
Who is this witness, Mr. Edward?
My witness saw the very moment when the steel samurai skewered the victim.
Order! I will have order! I see. The court will take a 10-minute recess, after which we will hear your witness. Court is adjourned for recess.
Recess and the Algonquin
Plan. Like, yeah, I was thinking the same thing.
I know that's not actually what it is, but it'd be funny for it, like, it just wants it, wouldn't it?
Yeah. What do we do now, Mia? Everyone in that trailer has an alibi.
I'm sorry, Phoenix. I guess I was wrong.
Mia? Don't tell me you're giving up. If you give up, what hope do I have?
Don't get me wrong. I've never given up on a trial before, not while there was a chance. Only one thing became clear in your cross-examination. The people in the trailer could not have gone to Studio 1. I thought there was more to it than that. But I was wrong. That's all there is.
What's going to happen to me? It kind of seems like everyone in the courtroom thinks I did it. They think I'm a murderer.
Don't worry, Mr. Powers. If you are innocent, we will prove it. I guarantee it. Leave it to us, and be yourself. Be strong. You are the Steel Samurai, hero to children everywhere, after all.
Thanks, Sniff.
Okay, Phoenix. This one's for the kids. Let's do it.
Court is back in session for the trial of Mr. Will Powers. The prosecution has a concern. As our witness is a grade schooler of 10 years, and this is a murder case, we worry that the defense might cause unnecessary trauma with his cruel questioning.
Nice to see Edward taking the moral high ground.
However, we have no choice. The prosecution calls Cody Hackens to the stand.
Like he's like hiding like...
Your Honor, perhaps you could arrange a box for him to stand on? Oh, right. Guard, please bring him a box. One of those donut crates should do.
Oh, goodness.
Will the witness state his name and grade in school? Witness!
What? Just because you're all grown up doesn't mean you can push me around.
Cody, answer his question, okay?
Hey, it's you, the nice lady. I'm Cody Hackens. I'm in second grade.
I get the feeling this is going to be a long, long day.
Mr. Wright, please remember that you're speaking to a child. Try to be gentle. Cody.
He's having trouble with this gentle thing.
You were present, you were at Google Studios on the day of the year incident?
You got a problem with that?
Please tell us what you saw that day.
What, Pops? You want me to tell you and Gramps with the beard over there?
I prefer bearded gentlemen myself.
A very long day.
Incidentally, photographic equipment is strictly forbidden in this courtroom. My apologies, Your Honor. He said he wouldn't testify if he couldn't bring it. I'd like special permission, if
that's possible.
Wait, so you're saying you had to bargain terms with a kid and you lost?
Hey, I just got this new camera. I don't really know how to use it all that good yet, but I bring it with me wherever I go.
Phoenix, I wonder if he had that camera on the day of the murder. You'd better make a note of it in the court record.
Very well, Cody. Please testify to the court about what you saw the day of the incident.
I wanted to see a Steel Samurai rehearsal, just once. I found a map on the internet and went to the studio that day. When I went through the woods, off-path so that old lady wouldn't catch me. I was going for the studio, but I got kind of lost on the way there, though, for about 30 minutes. And then I came out by the studio, there was a Steel Samurai. It totally rocked. Right before my eyes, out came the bad guy. Of course, the Steel Samurai took him down. Pow! If I had my camera with me, that would have been the time for a shot, I tell ya. Anyway, I couldn't get into the studio, so I went home.
Very well. The defense maybe begins in its cross-examination. But be gentle. Remember, you're talking to a child.
This kid is tougher than most adults we see in here, honestly. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
You really like the Steel Samurai, huh?
Of course I do! I tape every show, and I go to all the live performances!
That's impressive. Have you been to the amusement park?
Of course! Duh! My dad always takes me!
Poor dad. What? Was that day the first time you've been to the studio?
Actually, I've been there a couple times. I never managed to get there on rehearsal day. And that security lady is always yelling.
Right. Please continue.
Chill, Pops. I'm getting to it. How am I supposed to talk with you cutting me off like that all the time? Jeez.
Are you okay?
Mm-hmm.
You need to take your meds? Or are you good?
I'm good. I'm just shivering.
Okay. Off the path?
Yeah, you know, because the shoes are in a valley there. If you go off the path a little, there's woods. That's where I was.
I see.
Anyhow,
did nothing unusual happen on your way to the studio?
Unusual?
Did you see this monkey by any chance?
Oh, you mean Mr. Monkey? Yeah, I saw him, but his head wasn't busted.
So you went straight to the studio?
You got lost in the woods?
Yeah, I couldn't figure out which way I was walking. Man, I was relieved when I saw the blue studio doors. But guess what happened next?
The Steel Samurai?
Yeah, he was standing right by the studio gate. He looked like he was talking about something before going in.
Thinking.
Then he opened the gate and went inside.
I see. What then? What sort of bad guy was it?
A guy. A person. Kinda tall. Skinny.
Are you sure it was a guy?
I don't know. He was kinda far away.
He's being awfully vague. What happened to the bad guy?
Huh? Well, he kinda didn't move. Not a bit. Like he was dead. I guess he's a real pro. What a great actor.
Yes, I suppose he was. If you had your camera. You mean, you weren't carrying your camera then?
No, I wasn't. It's not like I have it all the time.
Really? I guess seeing the killing freaked him out, and he went home.
Phoenix, remember, he's a child. Use gentle words, but be firm.
Easy for you to say. Oh, whoops.
Was it...
Dang it, I didn't mean to press that. I meant to pull up my fucking evidence.
Oh, yeah. From the last one?
Yeah. Because...
Damn it!
Wow. Not what?
Oh, that's not gonna take that long.
I gotta pee!
Yeah, I gotta pee too, but I've been holding it for the in-between episodes.
So
you can hold it too!
Fine. Oh, look, you finally got it.
Yes, I did. Cody, what you just said seems, well, a little strange. Didn't you say before that you always bring your digital camera wherever you go? You were quite clear about that. Huh? Cody, you shouldn't lie here. You understand that, right?
Mr. Wright, a word with you.
Uh-oh. Was I putting on the pressure on a bit too much?
What is this digital camera contraption you're talking about?
It's, a digital camera, Your Honor. It's kind of a new sort of camera. How do I explain that?
I see.
Anyway, Cody, I can't believe you wouldn't bring your camera on a trip to the studio. You did bring it, didn't you?
Mr. Wright, how cruel are you to terrorize a poor child so?
I don't care if he's a child or a prosecuting attorney. No one should lie in court.
What do you mean, or a prosecuting attorney?
Well, Cody? What? Yeah, so I had my camera. So what? You got a problem with that?
So you did have a camera. And did you use this camera?
Why would I use it? I was too busy watching.
Very well. Please testify to the court about what you were so busy watching.
And on the next episode, we will get that witness testimony. See you guys then.
Bye!